play at altitude, and you've got guys like LeBron James who are just getting back into shape, like Anthony Davis just getting back into playing shape, and now in a couple of weeks here, 3 weeks really, you've got to start on the road against a team like the Nuggets, and you possibly have to win a game 7 in Denver,
right?
Let's give a little shout to the Denver Nuggets, who are really caught in the absence of Jamal Murray, which struggled mightily. Their first 8 games, they went 7-1 without him. Michael Porter Jr. has emerged as a frightening offensive weapon for them. Should also mention, regarding the Lakers, of course, that it's not a guarantee that they don't fall back into the play-in tournament with a loss today. Suns have the second best record in the league. The team they're playing, the Clippers, have the third best record. And with this loss, the Lakers are only a game up on Dallas for that sixth spot. We're talking about possibly playing Denver in the first round. And people thought the Clippers-Lakers could be a conference final. You can advance being a first-round series. So much can happen here in the next couple of weeks. This goes to Spurs and the play-in tournament, adding intrigue, especially for a team like Washington, which normally you're nothing to play for at this stage. But here they are, a team that really nobody wants to finish with the way Westbrook and Beal are playing. You got to knock them out twice in the play-in tournament. Washington's going to prove the 28-34 win for the 11th time in their last 13 games.
You're picking the Lakers or you're picking the championship right now?
You're asking me.
I'm taking the field.
Hard not to. Got to, right?
Yeah.
Just too many unknowns with the Lakers right now.
And I had said, you know, because you always get asked, who do you like, And even after watching them win the title last year, I'm still thinking, Brooklyn's healthy. I love Brooklyn.
It's interesting when we talk so much about maybe a conditioning for the Lakers. What about the Nets? What about James Harden? What about the chemistry? It wasn't an issue. It hasn't really been an issue for those three guys. And I guess that's the difference, right? With the Lakers, you have two superstars surrounded by a lot of really good players. But with the Nets, you have three superstars surrounded by a lot of really good players.
I think that's the important piece. Tom Burke's done a really nice job. I thought Spencer Dinwiddie would be missed, but they have done an incredible job. Actually, Bruce Brown contributing. Landry Shamet, who struggled upon arrival, is playing much better basketball.
LeBron going back to the locker room. He's seated off, and I don't think he's the only Laker fan that's seated off, as the Lakers fall to 36-26. They've lost 4 of their last 5. Washington has won 11 of its last 13.
Great coaches ever matching in history. 18 points, 18 rebounds for Russell. gets to the bucket.
14 assists.
Points now for
and he didn't
the
have his first turnover until the midway point of
the first quarter.
101 Baylor, 27 points. Anthony Davis at 26.
5.5 minutes to go.
In quarters 2 and 3, he just had one basket.
For three. Who's going to get that rebound? It's Jimmy Butler. Jimmy Butler. And a Who Wants It More scramble.
50-50 ball right there. And Jimmy comes up with a relentless. It was anybody's opportunity. He went down and got it.
8-point lead. Curry, corner three. Nope. Rebound right back to him. Kelvin Johnson scores over Bam. He's playing with four fouls. Kelvin Johnson now has a dozen points. The lead is six. Under 5 minutes to go.
Second is Anthony Davis. Also at 12 points.
Butler. Got fouled. Got the score again.
Getting ready here to talk with Cassidy.
Jimmy.
Go ahead, Cassidy. Take it away.
Jimmy.
Hey, Russ.
Making the energy and effort plays this one down on the floor. It's a tip situation. Anyone's ball, 50-50. He comes up with it, quick delivery to the backboard to get the 2 points, and then off the dribble, able to get the step on Walker, take the contact over Pearl. That's Jimmy Butler.